Hello students, today we are going to discuss about the new topic, house drainage system. Okay, you will see in detail what is the house drainage system and building utility and services. This is the content or syllabus regarding the house drainage system, that is the what is the principles of house drainage, pipes and traps, classification of traps depending upon the shapes and its uses, sanitary fittings, system of plumbing, house drainage plan. Moving further, so what is house drainage system? The WC, bathroom, sinks, wash basins, etc. are important components of a house, and the occupants or the residents of the house make use of the above components, and as a result of that there is a formation of wastewater. And the wastewater from WC, bathrooms, sinks and wash basins is to be properly disposed of into the municipal sewers. It is therefore necessary to construct a system of conveyance of wastewater from WC, bathrooms, kitchens and wash basins and disposal to the municipal sewer, and this system is known as the house drainage system. So broadly, the conclusion from this slide that while we are living in a residential house, we required WC, bathroom, sinks, wash basins, etc. and it is an important component of our house, and these components generate the wastewater, and these wastewaters are connected to the municipal sewers, and these municipal sewers carries the wastewater from the house to the point of disposal of the sewage. Therefore this system is known as the house drainage system. Moving further, this is the actual sketch of house drainage system, that what are the various components are associated with it. So this is the house, and the cross section of house is shown here, that it is the roof vents, that is the for the ventilating pipe, traps, drain, air cushions, washing machine stand pipes, and water heater, again trap, water meter to regularize or to judge the water consumption, water service line. Okay, this is the property service connection, and this is the clean outs, and this is the main sewer line which is adjacent to the road. So moving ahead, and we will see one by one in detail what is its means and what is the terminologies associated with this. So before studying the principles for design and construction of house drainage system, it is necessary to first understand the basic terms used in subsequent description of topics in the chapter. So important terms as follows, that is wastewater. We have gone through this wastewater in detail, but once again I am going to discuss it, that water when used in different purposes like domestic, commercial, industries, etc. receives impurities and become wastewater, and thus wastewater is used water, it has physical, chemical and biological impurities in it, and water wastewater is in general term we call this as wastewater. So what is a sewage? That the wastewater coming out from the WC and containing human excreta is known as the sewage. So in general term we will call this as wastewater. So that the water may comes out from various sources, from the domestic, from the commercial industry, etc. But what is the difference between wastewater and sewage? That is the sewage contains the wastewater coming out from the WC and contain human excreta and urine. Therefore it is known as the sewage. Other important terminologies, that is sewage, that is the wastewater coming out from the bathrooms and kitchen, but it does not contain the fecal matter. It is important, fecal matter is known as the sewage. Plumbing system, the entire piping system provided for the water supply to the building, or it is system for the pipe of disposal of wastewater from the building. Therefore it is known as the plumbing system. That is the one set of system is one piping system, that is the for the supply of water, and one piping system is for the collection of wastewater and for the disposal of wastewater from the building. And this whole system is known as the plumbing system. Sewer, that is the pipe carrying wastewater, is called sewer. Soil pipe, that is it's a pipe carrying sewage from wastewater, from WC. Once again, I am again repeating to you that a soil pipe is, it is a pipe carrying sewage from the WC. Now, waste pipe is, it's a pipe carrying sewage from bathrooms, kitchens, sinks, wash basins, etc. Okay, now the sewerage system. The sewerage system is the system of sewers of different types of pipes and size in a town, collecting wastewater and carrying it to the wastewater treatment plant. And this is the plumbing systems. This is a cross section of plumbing system. So it's assume it that it's a ground floor, it's a first floor, and it's a second floor of a building or of a house, and it is a attaching with the kitchen sinks and some bathrooms and WCs. So it is a soil stack, means the waste water will pass through it. That is the soil pipe. Means again, we have mentioned it that it is a pipe carrying the sewage from the WC. Therefore, it is mentioned it as soil pipes. Drain pipe, that is the waste which is carried by the kitchen sinks, and it is attached to the soil pipe, and the it is also attached with the bathroom. That is the drain, that is the wastewater, that is the sewage which is released from the bathroom, but it is free from the fecal pipe. So it is the cross section, or it is the piping system of one pipe system or single stack system, in which that is the sewage and sewage is passing through only the one pipe. That is, this is the one pipe. So it is a system. And lastly, it is the clean out system, means we will have to flush it out. So assume it that after some time, or after the passage of some time, if some clogging are occurred into the pipe, then we will provide a clean out or hair, and we will apply water into this, so that it will create a flushing act into the pipe, and it will flush out the clogging particles from the pipe, and hence the sewage will flow from the easily into the municipal sewer. And this is the vent pipe, means a ventilation should be properly given to the pipe, so that the foul gases or smell should be passed away, and it should be mixed into the environment or atmosphere. So definition of the terms, that is a manhole. These are the RCC or masonry chambers constructed at suitable intervals along the sewers, so that we can examine, or so that we can maintenance the sewerage system. So a manhole means a man can enter through that hole and can maintain or and inspect that sewerage system. Traps, it is an important terminology related to house plumbing system. Traps are defined as fittings at the end of soil pipes. This is the important terminology: fittings at the end of soil pipes, of waste pipes, to prevent foul gases coming out from the soil pipe or waste pipe. Means, in a simple word, I am going to explain you that traps means we have to arrest, means we have to remove. What we have to remove, or what we have to trap, means what we have to arrest, the foul gases. Foul gases, from where foul gases will generate? The foul gases which is moving or which is prevailing in the soil pipe or the plumbing system of the soil pipe. And hence, it should not enter into the houses through the WC chambers or through the bathrooms, so that it will create the foul atmosphere inside the house. And hence, these traps are provided at the end of the soil pipes, so that the foul gases, foul smells of that sewage or of that soil of human excreta of or sewage should not be come into the inside of the house or inside the WC chamber inside the bathroom section, and hence these traps are important for the removing of the foul gases. So first of all, we will discuss the principles of house drainage system. House drainage should be preferably laid by one side, by a side of the building, so that it should facilitate easily repair and better maintenance. So you have to understand that preferably laid by a side of the building, not on the between of the building, so that it can be easily repair and better maintenance. House sewers joint should be leak proof. It should be such joint that it should not create a leakage, because leakage, if any, shall create odor problem, and leaked waste water shall infiltrate in the ground and shall reduce the bearing capacity of soil below the foundation, which is not desirable. So we should have to avoid the leaky joints, and we have to avoid the we have to provide the sewer joint should be leak proof. Otherwise, it will reduce the bearing capacity of soil after the infiltration of that leakages below the foundation. Sewage or sludge should flow under the force of gravity. Means we should have to design the house drainage system in such a way that the sewage or sludge should flow under the action of the gravity. House sewer should be straight. Entire system should be well ventilated from start to the end. Otherwise foul gases will not be removed, will not be passed from the sewerage system, and it will create nuisance and it will move inside the pipeline. And hence, otherwise, if the proper ventilation is not occurred, otherwise then it will sometimes create cracks to the sewer system or piping system of the pipeline system or house plumbing system. Next point is, the house drainage should be connected to a manhole such that the invert level is sufficiently higher to avoid the backflow of the sewage. Means have to connect to the manhole. First of all, the sewer should be connected to the manhole such that the invert level, means the opposite level or the inverse level, should be sufficiently high to avoid the backflow. Means the sewage, once they pass from the one end, say from the point A, should not be reversed, should not be backflow from the point B in the house sewers. Wherever there is a chance in direction of sewer line in the premises, provide the inspection chamber at the junction. Means wherever there is a chance in direction of sewer, means if there is a chances in direction, change in direction in the sewer, we should have to provide the inspection chamber at the junction. Rainwater from the roofs or open courtyard should not be allowed to flow through the house sewers. Why? Because it will create the additional flow or additional pressure into the house sewers, and hence it will provide the leakages from the sewers. Siphonage action can never be permitted, and therefore adequate ventilation should be installed. So these are the principles of house drainage should be maintained while designing the house plumbing system. So moving ahead. So traps and pipes and other components of house drainage system. Following are the main components of house drainage system, that is pipes, traps and sanitary fittings. Means while designing the house plumbing system, these three things should be focused while designing this. So first of all, traps. We have just seen that traps means a device which is used to arrest the foul gases. So in simple words, pipes means media from which the wastewater carries from one end to another end, and the sanitary fittings means the taps, the walls, etc., which is used to assist for us for the proper functioning or for the proper utilization of the sewerage system or from the house plumbing system. So the traps and pipes and other components of house drainage system. Following are the main components of house drainage system. First, traps. Good traps should have following qualities. Means which qualities? It should provide enough water seal. This is very important thing. Water seal means the traps which arrest the foul gases. It consists or it is achieved with the help of water seal. And which, how much water seal should be maintained? That it should maintain around 50 mm, that it should contain the water seal of about 50 mm with large surface area. Interiors surface should be smooth so that the flow is not obstructed, which enables the self cleansing. Means the interior surface of the trap should be such, it should be so smooth that the flow is not obstructed, which enables the self-cleansing. An access door should be provided for the cleaning of the trap, and it should be made of non-adsorbent material. So these should be the qualities of a good trap. That is, first, what is the main quality? First, you should have to remember that is the, it should maintain a good water seal of about 50 mm. Second, the interior surface should be so smooth that it should not it should maintain the self cleansing velocity, and it should not obstruct the waste to flow. Second, an access door should be provided for the cleaning of the trap, and lastly, that it should not be maintained of non-adsorbent material. Now, the classification of the traps. The traps are classified depending upon the shapes. Now, which shape? That is the three types: P trap, Q trap, and S traps. Above three traps are shown in the following figures. So these are the three traps. That is P, Q, and S. That is depending upon the shapes. And why it is shapes? Because these resembles to the shapes of the alphabets P, Q, and S traps. So this is the P trap. This is the Q trap, and this is the S traps. So we will see in detail about each and every trap. So the PQ and S traps, classification of traps depending upon the shapes and traps. The traps are classified as follows, that is P trap, Q trap, and S traps. Above three traps are shown in the following figure. That is, first, P trap. This is the water seal, means it is an inverted P. And this is the inlet. Assume it is that this end is fixed with the water, fixed with the seat or the pan of the WC or the seat of the WC, and the waste is discharged and it is collected at this portion. And this is the crown of the trap, and this is the dip of the crown of the trap. So, and this is the water seal. And this, how much seal? That is the difference between the water level between crown and dip is called the water seal. And we have just now discussed the quality of the traps, that it should maintain 50 mm of water seal. So depending upon this seal, this water is always maintained in this trap. Similarly, this is the Q trap. It's the discharging point or the discharging angle. It is somehow bended, and it is resembled to the shape of Q. Again, the phenomena is same, that this end is connected to the seat and this end is connected to the pipe, that is the discharge pipe. Similarly, the difference between the crown and dip is known as the water seal. Similarly, and this is the S traps, that the shape is similar to the alphabet S, and the difference between the crown and dip is called as the water seal. And minimum 50 mm water seal is should be maintained. So this in all three all three traps, it has been observed that the water seal is maintained properly in the S traps, because it is difficult to move water seal from this this angle or this pipe, and how the waste is moved from the trap, because once the waste is discharges into this pipe or into this trap, the flushing action will takes place, and it forces water to move from this action, from that dip to crown, and hence it carries water from dip to crown, and hence the waste is moved from crown to the discharging point, and hence the remaining, after the flushing action over, the remaining water will takes place or will remain as it is into the this water seal or into this section of the trap, and hence this water seal always maintain, and hence the waste on the foul smell moving into the pipe of the or the waste pipe in the sewerage system will not travel through that, will arrest it into this point and will not travel through this water seal, and hence it cannot be comes out by passing through this water seal and into the ambience, and hence these traps are very important component as far as the sewerage system or house plumbing system is concerned. So this is a very important classification regarding the shape is concerned, that is P trap, Q trap and S trap. That is first of all you have to understand that is the difference between the crown and dip is called the water seal, and minimum 50 mm water seal should be maintained, and this is the first collecting point, this is the discharging point, and waste is collected from this end and discharges from this point, and the flushing action will take place at this section of the trap, and hence the after the flushing action over, the water, remaining water in the trap will get as it is. So moving ahead, so based on the use, the traps are classified as floor traps, that is Nahani traps is sometimes called in India, gully traps, intercepting traps, all the above traps are discussed below. Floor traps, this trap is generally used to admit sewage from the floors of rooms, bathrooms, kitchen, etc. into the sewage pipe. This is provided with cast iron or stainless steels or galvanized gratings, that is we have called jalis in India or in local language, at its top, so that the entry of larger matter is prevented, thereby chances of blockage are reduced. A commonly used name of trap is Nahani trap. So how the Nahani trap is looks like, so it is generally provided into the bathrooms. Similarly, the gully trap is provided at the junction of the roof drain and the other drain coming out from the kitchen or a bathroom, as shown in the figure below. And the foul sewage shall enter through the side inlet, which is collected at the back inlet, and unfouled rainwater collected from the top, which is covered with the cast iron grating. The gully traps may be either P or P shape or Q shape water sealing arrangement. The water seal is normally 50 mm to 75 mm. So this is the actual figure of the gully trap, that is at the top it is connected with the roof drain, that is the rainwater drain, and at the bottom it is connected with the drain which is coming from the kitchens or bathrooms. So it is generally provided at the junction of the gully or at the passage of the house drain, so it is known as the gully traps. So this is the cross section view of the gully trap. This is the we will provide the gratings, that is the cast iron gratings at the roof or courtyard level, This is the sewage from the bathrooms or kitchens, and sometimes it is directly connected into the roof from the roof pipe. And this is the water seal is maintained, and it seems to be the sometimes it is S traps or S to be P traps, and this is lastly it is connected to the house drainage or sewage pipes. Now lastly it is intercepting traps. Intercepting traps are the traps is provided at the junction of the house sewer and municipal sewers for preventing entry of foul gases of municipal sewer into the house drainage systems. Intercepting trap is provided in the manual as shown in the following figure. Means it is a trap means which is connecting the house and the municipal sewer, and it is used to prevent the entry of foul gases of municipal sewer into the house drainage system. So how it seems to be, there are two inlets. This is the larger inlet point which is generally used to connect the municipal sewer. This is the point, or this is the pipe which is used to connect the house drainage pipe, and these are two lids are provided and which is generally closed. If some cleaning or some blockages are occur or some clogging are occur, so we will use to clean that these traps using this pipes. So sometimes, or if sometime additional pipes are there, so which is used to connect, so we can connect it by using these points. So this is known as the intercepting traps. So again, this is the cross-sectional view of intercepting traps. It is a tight fitting plug, that is, this is the plug you will generally use to provide or lid calling cleaning eye. We will use it for the flushing, or it is sometimes called as the inspection arm. This is the inspection arm, and this is the inlet from the house. This is the inlet from the house, and this is the outlet to the street sewer. So what are the advantages of intercepting traps? Foul gases of larger municipal sewers are prevented from entering house drainage system. Harmful pathogens are not entered in the house drainage, and well designed and constructed interceptors can quickly remove the foul matter of house drainage to municipal sewer. So these are the advantages. Similarly, disadvantages are also associated. Heavy matters shall retain in the trap if the discharge of wastewater is small and the small decompose producing four gases, and thus the main purpose of preventing fall is not served at all. So you have to understand the main disadvantage, that the heavy matter shall retain in the trap, and if the discharge of wastewater is small and the small decompose producing foul gases, and thus main purpose of preventing foul gases is not served at all. When the plug is broken, the foul gases shall enter the house sewers. The cleaning through the inspection area is difficult. The interceptor itself is an obstruction to the smooth flow. Omission of interceptor may have not raised serious consequences. If we have not provided this, it may have not serious consequences. Presence of interceptor installed by the owner is found to affect ventilation of municipal sewer, and hence if interceptors are allowed, more ventilation systems are to be provided for public or municipal sewers, which increase the cost of sewerage system and therefore increasing the taxes too. Because of the above reason, municipalities decided whether to allow the owner to provide intercepting traps or not. Means it is the completely consist of some advantages and some disadvantages, and it is the municipalities and municipal corporation have not made it mandatory to the consumer or to the owner that you have to fix it or not. So this is all about the house drainage system which we have studied till now, and especially the main content which I have to cover is the traps. So hope you have understand the concept behind this. And if you have any doubt related to this, please post the queries into the comment section. The house unit system is not over yet, and the second part of the house unit system is related to the pipe and sanitary fittings will be covered in the next lecture. Please connect it to it. Thank you, and thank you very much.